Hi, thanks for joining me in another episode of Why Not Go. Thank you again for liking my previous videos, my David Bowie, my Sex Pistols, and all the other videos. This video is a little different. I guess every video is a little different. This is a little different. I just wanted to talk about the Sex Pistols records, even though, of course, everyone knows they only had the one album, Never Mind the Bollocks, but there's also lots of other records that I'm sure people have probably a lot more than I do, but I do have a few that I just kind of wanted to chat with, and maybe everyone can ask themselves and put a comment if they want to, what's their favorite Sex Pistols record. So starting with, of course, the classic. It doesn't get any more classic than this. Never Mind the Bollocks. Here's the Sex Pistols. I have the pink cover, and it came out in October. I think it was late October, 1977. And I remember I was at the Mask, which is a punk club in L.A., and I saw they were playing Sex Pistols songs, and I kept listening. I kept thinking, I don't think this is live. I think this is an album, and the album wasn't out yet, but they had the cover there in the club. I saw it near the DJ booth, and it was a yellow cover. So again, I'm not a vinyl expert, but I think the yellow cover was the UK issue, and when I bought it in October of 1977, when it came out in America, I'm pretty sure they were all with the pink cover. So it's pink on the front and green on the back. And this has seen a lot of airplay in all the places I've lived over my life so far. Love the album. I will say that, and this is just a minor point, when I first saw the cover, I didn't like it. I don't know why. I was expecting maybe a picture of the band on the cover. And I love Jamie Reed's artwork. Jamie Reed was their art director. And he was also the boyfriend of Sophie Richmond, I believe was her last name. And she was Malcolm's secretary. She's the one that I met in the office when I delivered the jacket to Steve Jones in my Sex Pistols on Tour video. So her boyfriend was Jamie Reed, the artist. And I loved his artwork. I love the Ransom style lettering. It's still so classic. But that's just a minor thing. I don't know. I just thought, I thought, oh, there's no picture of the band on the cover. What's going on? So, but I love it. I love it. There's nothing I don't love about this album. And it just shows what great songwriters that they were in their short time together. And then, oh, by the way, in the background, I just have it on low, but in my tiki room, I have a little stereo. It's not a great stereo here, but I'm playing this, and I love this record. I play it a lot. Burton on Trent Recordings. This one was recorded in the summer of 1976, and Burton on Trent, I think, is a town outside of London, but I love this album. I'm playing it on low here so I can talk over it, but I love this album. The band sounds, it sounds like in the summer of 1976, to me, it sounds like they were really, I don't know, firing on all cylinders. Glenn was still in the band, of course. There's a picture of them on the back. I go through phases, but a lot of the time in the past couple years, I think I play this one more than anything because it really captures them and their, I don't know, and their purity, I guess. I don't know if people talk about the Sex Pistols as being pure, but they just sound great on this album. I just love it. I love this album. I think it was produced by Dave Goodman or recorded by Dave Goodman, who was their sound engineer. And I guess he went to their third ever gig, and from then on, he was their sound man. So he saw more shows than I think anybody in the UK, Dave Goodman. So I love this record. I play it a lot. It just shows you when a band writes such great songs, God, I didn't think I'd get emotional. I'm getting emotional already. When a band writes such great songs, they kind of don't even need to be produced. I just love this album so much. So I'm playing that in the background. The other album that I want to talk about just briefly. This is a short video. But this album I got just before Never Mind the Bollocks came out. I think it came out in September, maybe August or September. Never Mind the Bollocks came out in October. And this is called the Spunk Album. And I really like this album. And I think when Never Mind the Bollocks came out, again, this is just my opinion, and I kind of still think this, that I kind of prefer the Spunk Album. I feel like Never Mind the Bollocks was a little more produced, especially Johnny's vocals. They're kind of a little bit more sped up or something. I don't know what it is, but they're kind of a little more sped up on Never Mind the Bollocks and a little more raw and natural on the Spunk Album. And so this is an original Spunk Album. I don't know, it has a number on there, 414. I don't know if it's worth anything. It might be worth $50. My husband went through my records because I have so many. He says, you need to know what this stuff is worth. Not that I'm going to give it away or sell it or anything. But anyway, so it has a number on it. But I really love this album, and that's the label there. It just says blank Spunk. And then, the sound quality isn't as good, but I do kind of prefer it to Never Mind the Bollocks in the way that the sound quality isn't as good, but Johnny's vocals were really left raw on this album, and whereas Never Mind the Bollocks, it's a little more produced. So as far as his vocals go, I just love Spunk. I still love this album. So, and I'll just play Anarchy on the Spunk Album and then Anarchy on the Never Mind the Bollocks, so you can kind of see what I mean. All right, so this is Anarchy in the UK on the Spunk Album on my stereo in my tiki room. I think you could, yeah. This is going to be Anarchy in the UK on Never Mind the Bollocks. Good production. Not much of a difference, I don't know, but I still think that, and again, I don't want to sound like a vinyl train spotter or something, but I still think the vocals on this are more natural, and the vocals on Never Mind the Bollocks are a little more, I don't know, it's almost like Johnny singing like an octave higher, or just a little bit, I don't know, just a little different, like a little bit sped up or something. Whereas this, it's like a very raw vocal. But anyway, they're both great. I mean, full stop, they're both great. So, and I'd be curious to see what other people think. It's still so sad they only had one album. It's just one of the tragedies of rock and roll. This record I love. I like a lot of their live records. This one was recorded in 1976. And I don't know. I can't remember. I know it's live, but I don't know if it's at the 100 Club or where it is. But this is a great, it's like a little mini album. It just has a few songs on it. Submission, 17, Satellite, I Wanna Be Me, Anarchy, and No Feeling. So that's a great one. I love this one. I'm just going to go through some live ones. As I said, I think my favorite one that I'm playing now, and hopefully you can hear me, I've got it on low. I think this is my favorite one, the Burton on Trent recordings. And again, this was done in the summer of 1976. And I love it when you hear the audience. I've got it playing there. They're playing New York. I love it when you hear the audience clapping. It sounds like there's about 5 or 10 people in the audience, which it probably was just about 5 or 10 people in the audience. And they were just, I don't know, in their prime, I think, the summer of 1976, definitely. I think their prime lasted a while longer, obviously, but they were really firing on all cylinders. And then this is another live album that I have, and I think it's very similar. It's also in Burton on Trent, but although I think the playlist is a little different. So I don't know if this is another gig at the same venue, but this is also Burton on Trent, and this is another great, great live album. I love the cover on that one. And then I have, you know, because obviously they didn't have only the one studio recording. They had a lot of live recordings. This was done at the 100 Club in September of 1976. Great cover, of course. I also love this one. I haven't played it in a while, but I think that I do remember the audience does sound like there's quite a few people there. I think that it was pretty packed at these shows, whereas Burton on Trent, I don't know if there was many shows. This one is another live one, and I can't, Sid's on the cover, so I'm assuming it was maybe the Spots or maybe in Sweden. I don't know. I don't think it's in the U.S. Belson was a Gas is on this one, so I kind of have a feeling this is in Sweden. I can't remember, but I love that live album. And then, of course, this one that I've talked about in my Sid Vicious video when I met him. This is the show that I went to at the Electric Ballroom in 1978. August 15th, 1978, has a good picture on the back. I love this album too. And he is a good vocalist. I think his vocals were really good, and I think they would have developed even more as he went along. This is a neat record. I don't know if, I don't know exactly when I bought this one, Sid Lives. And, it's neat because it has a whole history of Sid and the Sex Pistols here. And this album's interesting. It's kind of a good compliment to the Electric Ballroom, because Electric Ballroom was his only live show in the UK. And then this is a record that it chronicles his live shows in New York up until when Nancy passed away. So this is shows in Max's Kansas City, and I forget, I should read the liner notes, but he might have played CBGB's, but I think it's all at Max's Kansas City. So you've got at least 4 shows on this one, so that's neat. It's a good it's a really good album, and Johnny Thunders is on this one too, so that's neat to hear his guitar playing, and Mick Jones played with him. This is another Sid one, and love the cover. I kind of forgot what was on this one, but I think it's I believe it's on Virgin. I believe it's Recordings. Yeah, Something Else, Search and Destroy. I think it's a combination of Recordings and live music that Sid did, and Virgin put this out. Love that one. And this is another one. I love the cover. I love covers. Covers of albums. I love this picture of him and Nancy. She's wearing a seditionary sweater there, of course. And this is another album that his live shows in New York. And it's called Love Kills New York City. So that's another good one if you like to listen to Sid live. And then this is another one I have. It's just kind of a short little kind of mini album. Anarchy in the UK band. This is actually a 45. So I Want to Be Me and Anarchy. I don't know when this came out, but that's actually like a 45, even though it's big. And this is another one here. I love the cover on that one with the girl. And this is another early recording. This is great. This has Submission on it and also Anarchy in the UK. Love that photo there. And this is great. So this is another single that licensed through Dave Goodman, who was their sound engineer. And this is Submission and Anarchy in the UK. I believe these are, it says it was recorded on a 4-track recorder at Riverside Studio. So that's not a live album, that's a single that's recorded in a studio. And this is Some Product. Obviously this came out after Sid died. So I think this is a mixture of the Sex Pistols and Sid. I haven't played that one in a while. This is kind of a cute album. I don't know where I got this, but this is just kind of a mixture. I love all the little stuff on it. A mixture of Come On Everybody that Sid did, and then also Sex Pistols, Anarchy in the UK, I Want to Be Me, Satellite, My Way. So that's neat. That's all the tracks there. They might be all live. I think this is a live album. All right, so the last album that I have, I never liked the title, Flogging a Dead Horse. This came out after the band broke up, and basically has Sex Pistols songs on one side, and then on the other side it has sort of post-Sex Pistols songs, like No One Is Innocent. That's the one that they did with Ronnie Biggs. Steve Jones and Ronnie Biggs wrote that. My Way, The Great Rock and Roll Swindle, Sid doing Come On Everybody, something else. So it's kind of a combination of Pistols on one side and then kind of post-Pistols on the other side. It's okay. I don't know. I don't like the title, but you know, it's not bad, especially side one with the Sex Pistols songs. You can't go wrong with that. So I just wanted to do a records Sex Pistols records video. I hope you enjoyed it. I think my all-time favorite Sex Pistols records are obviously the classic Never Mind the Bollocks. Great album, beautiful album. And then Spunk, which is kind of Never Mind the Bollocks, but more raw. Obviously a very primitive cover. I love that. But I love Spunk if you want sort of Sex Pistols raw in the studio. I love this record. And then I think my favorite live record, which I'm playing now on low volume, is Burton on Trent recordings in the summer of 1976, recorded by Dave Goodman, their sound engineer. And just to give you an idea what great songwriters they were, in the summer of 76, their first rehearsal was August 75. First show was November of 75. So they hadn't been going long in the summer of 76, like barely rehearsing a year and only playing about maybe 7 or 8 months. And they'd already written Anarchy in the UK, New York, Satellite, Submission, No Feelings, I Want to Be Me, 17, Liar, Pretty Vacant and Problems. And I'm sure other songs too, but those are the songs that are on this album. Just amazing songwriting talent that came out of these very talented four young men. So anyway, I hope you liked going back through time and looking at the Sex Pistols records. I'd be curious to see what other people's opinions are, what they like the most. I'm assuming Never Mind the Bollocks, rightly so, would be everyone's favorite record. I'd be curious to know what everyone's, maybe people's favorite live albums are. But this is mine, Summer of 1976, the Sex Pistols. Well, thanks for joining me on another episode of Why Not Go. And until the next time, I'll be seeing you.